The Department of Interior and local government vehemently denies the rehabilitation of Manila Bay is part of a plan to launch reclamation projects in the area. That's after the Makabayan Bloc filed a resolution at the House of Representatives calling for the suspension of the rehabilitation. But Anakpawi's Representative Ariel Casilao insists, while the DILG may not be aware of such plans, the National Reclamation Authority has already released its proposal for Manila Bay.
Ang nakapagtataka nga, Christian, a part of the government, an agency of the government, is releasing several press releases, in particular the National Reclamation Authority, the NRA, that they have drafted a plan, the National Reclamation Plan for 2019, which form parts the Build
program,
a priority, a pet project of President Duterte, which includes 43 reclamation projects in Manila Bay. And this document is a public document.
DILG Assistant Secretary Jonathan Malaya says his department will seek a dialogue with the National Reclamation Authority. He urges the Makabayan Bloc to do the same.
Hindi na po sila kailangan mag-file ng resolution seeking for the suspension or delay in the rehabilitation of Manila Bay simply because it is a guise for reclamation. Ngayon, tungkol naman po doon sa sinasabi na these are two agencies of government. Totoo po yan, these are two agencies of government, and the Philippine Reclamation Authority has their own mandate. So, ang siguro po ang gagawin namin, kakausapin namin ng Philippine Reclamation Authority, no? And since the Makabayan Bloc is also part of government, they can also do something about it. Maybe they can ask or call for a hearing in Congress requesting the Philippine Reclamation Authority to appear before Congress to explain how are they going to do the reclamation projects and how it will impact on Manila Bay rehabilitation.
On Thursday, the Environment Department of Central Luzon issued a cease and desist order to 15 business establishments in Marilao and Meycauay and Bulacan on Thursday. These establishments, mostly factories, were discharging wastewater in the Marilao, Meycauay and Obando River system, which is connected to the Manila Bay. This leather tannery in Meycauay dumps its wastewater into the Meycauay River.
Dahil sa pag-overflow na yan, no, direct discharge na siya dun sa river mismo.
Environment Management Bureau officials sealed the outfall of the establishment to prevent more wastewater discharge. A representative of the tannery refused to be interviewed but told ABS-CBN News they will implement corrective measures. A chicken dressing plant in Marilao, Bulacan was also issued a CDO.
Dahil yung capacity was designed for a wastewater na 300 cubic meters per day. Pero dahil nag-expand sila, no, more than 400 cubic meters per day na yung wastewater. So hindi na kayanan ng wastewater treatment facility.
The Environment Department said there will be more CDOs to be issued in the coming days, with inspections being done every day. Meanwhile, DENRLLDA released the new list of CDOs, ex parte order and notice of violation in different commercial establishments around Manila Bay. Cease and desist orders were issued versus 4 establishments, 3 ex parte orders and notice of violation for water pollution versus 7 more, including the GSIS building. Cory Quintos, ABS-CBN News.